At DataStax, we create Langflow, which is a really, really great way to build and deploy production AI applications. It's a visual builder where you wire together a bunch of components that invoke an AI workflow to generate applications, perform RAG, or even build agents. Once your workflow is built and modeled, you can then expose it over an HTTP endpoint and consume it in any web application. It's actually very, very cool. However, if you wanted to go use Langflow, there's friction, right? Like if you open this is datastax.com. And if you go to Langflow and try to get started, like the first thing you'll see is a signup form and we'll have you log in. But you're supposed to log into something that you don't get to use. And there's a really powerful lesson here that I want to take to heart and implement. And this lesson comes from the great Guillermo Rauch, the CEO and founder of Vercel, who says a huge percentage of the feedback that I find myself giving to early stage founders boils down to remove the friction between the user and the creation of the core entity or resource that your company is facilitating. In the case of DataStax, the company, core resource we want to facilitate with Langflow is one of these flows, these AI workflows that you can use in an application. So it's a question of removing friction. In that spirit, I'm happy to announce today the beta and early release of Langflow.new, which is just frictionless access to Langflow to create that resource, a flow. Let me show you. So if we go to langflow.new, you can just use Langflow now. You don't have to sign up. You don't have to do anything. It's just right here. This is a flow for an AI agent where you just pop in an OpenAI API key and go. You can watch a full tutorial on how to build an agent here, but maybe you don't want to build an agent. You can just like get rid of everything and just use Langflow to build any AI application. Instead of an agent, maybe you just want a wrapper on a language model. So you have a chat input and a chat output. Let's go get OpenAI, and you can use Olama, you can use Mistral, you can use whatever you want. And we'll wire up the chat input to the input and the model's output to the chat output. And just like, and let's add an API key here. And just like that, we have, you know, a wrapper on hi, how are you? We have a wrapper on GPT 4.0 mini. Look at that, incredible. But what if we wanted to do more? What if we wanted to do RAG, that is retrieval augmented generation? What if we wanted to retrieve context from somewhere and augment the generated output? For example, what if we wanted to just like chat with a PDF? Can we do that? We can. So in Langflow, you can go to data, choose file, and here you can just like upload a file. So what if I wanted to chat with this paper? Attention is all you need. The origin story of like chat, the language model behind ChatGPT, GPT-3, right? It's a transformer architecture model. And this paper explains how that works. So what if I wanted to chat with this? Well, I just upload the PDF and now I get data. So what I'll do is I'll parse this data into a string. So I'll just take the data, put it here. And now I get to construct a prompt with my question and the context. So I'll take prompt as a component and we'll construct a prompt. Given this context, and we'll make a variable context, answer the question. And variables are in these curlies right here. So I'll check and save. And now look at this. I give context from the PDF. I give the question from the chat input into this prompt that I then send as input to the language model. Look at that. I've got RAG on my PDF in Langflow. Let's test it. So I'll be like, I'll just start a new conversation, explain as short as possible the TLDR of this paper. And now it's going to take that PDF, read it, and give us, this paper introduces the transformer, a novel neural network architecture. How cool is that? For sequence transduction tasks. That, what is that? Answer shortly, what is sequence transduction tasks, right? And so it's just going to reach into that PDF and its existing knowledge base and be like, here, sequence transduction tasks involve transforming one sequence of data into another. We are effectively chatting with this PDF. We can even ask like, who are the authors of this paper? And just to be sure, we have the context from our PDF. If I send this, the authors are Ashish Vaswani, Noam Shazir, Nikki Parma. Let's just check. Ashish Vaswani, Noam Shazir. So it's like, we did that with Langflow right here. And we can now expose it over an HTTP API for any application we want to use. Now, once you understand this value for your use case and you want to expose it over an API, we need to introduce authentication. Like, we need to know who you are so you don't abuse our API, right? And this is where we'll prompt you to make an account, but the friction is gone from time to value. As mentioned, this is a technical preview. It's a beta. We may have some capacity limits and so on, so be kind. But we want to encourage you, go play. Play with Langflow like you never have. There's no friction. And we can't wait to see what you build. Share it with us. Mention at DataStaxDevs or reach out on Twitter or Discord. We're more than happy to hear from you. And again, we can't wait to see what you build. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.